In the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us prepare ourselves to celebrate this Holy Eucharist. Let us call to mind our sinfulness and let us be sorry for them. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
Let us pray. O God, who on this day revealed your only begotten Son to the nations by the guidance of a star, grant in your mercy that we who know you already by faith may be brought to behold the beauty of your sublime glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Rise up and splendor, Jerusalem. Your light has come. The glory of the Lord shines upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick clouds covers the peoples. But upon you the Lord shines, and over you appears his glory. Nations shall walk by your light, and kings by your shining radiance. Raise your eyes and look about. They all gather and come to you. Your sons come from afar, and your daughters in the arms of their nurses. Then you shall be radiant at what you see. Your heart shall throb and overflow, for the riches of the sea shall be emptied out before you. The wealth of nations shall be brought to you. Caravans of camels shall fill you. dromedaries from Midian and Ephah. All from Sheba shall come, bearing gold and frankincense, and proclaiming the praises of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. O God, with your judgment endow the king, and with your justice the king's son. He shall govern your people with justice, and your afflicted ones with judgment. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. Justice shall flower in his days, and profound peace till the moon be no more. May he rule from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. The kings of Tarshish and the isles shall offer gifts. The kings of Arabia and Sheba shall bring tribute. All kings shall pay him homage. All nations shall serve him. Lord, every nation on earth will adore. For he shall rescue the poor when he cries out, and the afflicted when he has no one to help him. He shall have pity for the lowly and the poor. The lives of the poor he shall serve. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you have heard of the stewardships of God's grace that was given to me for your benefit, namely, that the mystery was made known to me by revelation. It was not made known to people in other generations, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit, that the Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia,
Alleluia,
Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. We saw his star at its rising, and have come to do him homage. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of King Herod, behold, Magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is the newborn King of the Jews? We saw his star rising and have come to do him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Assembling all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea. For thus it has been written through the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, since from you shall come a ruler who is to be shepherd my people Israel.' Then Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained from them the time of the star's appearance. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, 'Go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me word, that I too may go and do him homage.' After their audience with the king, they set out. And behold, the star that they had seen at its rising preceded them until it came and stopped over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed at seeing the star, and on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. They prostrated themselves and did him homage. They opened their treasures and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their country by another way." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Before Christmas, my wife traveled to Boston to help our daughter care for our four grandchildren while her husband was away. Though she was born on December 14th, 2018, our granddaughter was named Lucia, after St. Lucy. Early on the morning of this past December 13th, the feast day of St. Lucy, my wife was sleeping soundly in a pitch black room when a noise at the door woke her. She saw a circle of light enter the room and move around her bed, stopping next to her head. And standing there was our granddaughter, the three-year-old Lucia, with a crown of candles on her head as St. Lucy, carrying a plate of Lucy buns. The dramatic effect of the light coming into the darkness was made more dramatic by the innocence, the sweetness, and the love of the child bearing gifts to Gamma. Light and love brought into a darkened world. The prophet Isaiah speaks of darkness covering the earth and the light and the glory of the Lord shining on Jerusalem. Then all the nations traveling to Jerusalem by the light bearing gifts, and proclaiming the praises of the Lord. In the gospel, we hear of the Magi, wise men from the east, looking into the heavens and seeing a light that the Lord had put into the sky for them to see, the star announcing the birth of a king, the King of the Jews. In the darkness of the long winter nights, they saw that light and they moved, following the star, traveling, seeking to give homage to and bring gifts to this newborn king. When they arrived in Jerusalem, they asked for directions, for they did not know where to go. I said they were wise men. Imagine men asking for directions. Then darkness enters this story as King Herod heard about their inquiry. Certainly Herod the Great, with his pride, selfishness, and brutality, was an agent of darkness in the world, in stark contrast to the light and love of Christ. He summoned his own wise men, the Jewish chief priests and scribes, to learn about the Christ. With that knowledge, Herod now had a choice. He could choose a path of light and love and join the Magi as they go to worship Jesus, the true King of the Jews, or choose to continue in darkness. True to his nature, Herod chooses darkness. He schemes to have the Magi help him locate the baby Jesus so he can be destroyed. The next story in Matthew tells of St. Joseph's dream and the Holy Family's flight to Egypt before Herod has all the male babies, 2 years old and under, in and around Bethlehem, slaughtered. Light and love. Jesus Christ came into the world to battle darkness, and by the grace of God, he escaped to Egypt and returned when it was safe. Each year, the church gives us the story of Christmas, the Word of God, the love of God, taking on a human form as Jesus the Christ to bring his light, his love into and for the whole world. And we have the choice each year, or really every moment of our lives, to let go of any attachments, any darkness within us that stops us from receiving the light and love our Lord wants to give us, so we can bring his light and love into this darkened world. Yes, we have a little bit of that selfish King Herod inside of us, but also a little of the Magi, seeking the Lord, following the light, spreading the good news of our Lord's love, and maybe asking for directions when we don't know where to go. This Christmas season and beyond, let us all choose to be like that 3-year-old granddaughter, joyfully bringing light and love into the darkness of the world around us. Peace.
Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate with the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, that his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pause now to pray for all in need, especially those who seek the light of truth.
For the church, that we may reflect the light of Christ in the words we preach and the actions we take, so that light may shine forth to all people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For every nation on earth, may they come to adore the Lord and follow God's ways of peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who work to uphold the value and dignity of all human life, that they may be sustained in their efforts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our community of faith, that we will be unafraid to go beyond the walls of our church and reach out to those in need. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those on our website's Vigil Light List and written in our Book of Prayer Intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the relief and comfort of the sick, especially those suffering from COVID-19. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, that the light of the newborn Christ might be a guiding light of comfort and peace, and for Pedro Mesanque, whose one-year death anniversary we remember this week. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Good and gracious God, hear the prayers we raise to you and answer them according to your will, for we trust in your guiding light. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Of the fathers of begotten, ere the words began to be, he is Alpha and Omega, he the source of ending. Of the things that are that have been, and that future evermore and evermore. Blessed was the day forever when the Virgin, full of grace, by the Holy Ghost conceived, bore the Savior of our race. The child, the world's Redeemer, first revealed his sacred face, evermore and evermore.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good, all his holy church.
Look with favor, Lord, we pray on these gifts of your church, in which are offered now not gold or frankincense or myrrh, but he who by them is proclaimed, sacrificed, and received, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ as a light for the nations. And when he appeared in our mortal nature, you made us new by the glory of his immortal nature. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took that chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Robert, John, Ramon, our bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
At a Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ has said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
The first Noel angel did say was to certain poor shepherds in fields as they lay, in fields where they lay keeping their sheep on a cold winter's night that was so deep. No.
The act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things and a desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Go before us with the heavenly light, O Lord, always and everywhere, that we may perceive with clear sight and revere with true affection the mystery in which you have willed us to participate. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Angels we have.